Welcome to 21st Sports. Week 2 is underway, and we're talking the Cincinnati Bengals versus the Pittsburgh Steelers in this AFC North Division rivalry matchup played September 18, 2016. And when these two get together, it is always fun to watch, that's for sure, as they give it their all, their fierce rivals. We remember last time they played, but this one was a little more civil, not so many penalties, only the one personal foul. But it was all about that defense, specifically that Steelers defense. The Steelers defense is playing at a very high level right now. It's only two games in, but they are looking like they are going very far this season, and this game goes a long way towards that, getting a big win against their division rival. Of course, it was in Pittsburgh, but still getting a win in division against the team that's right there going to be competing with you for the division title. This is a big win for the Steelers. It all started off with a 20-yard touchdown from Ben Roethlisberger to Xavier Grimble to make it 7-0 in the first, late in the first quarter. Then Mike Nugent added the Bengals' first points of the game just seconds before the end of the first quarter. So 7-3 after one. And then Chris Boswell kicked a 49-yard field goal for the Steelers to make it 10-3. Nugent then added another three for the Bengals with a 33-yarder. His time expired in the first half. So it was a 4-point game at halftime. A very close, hard-fought game at this point. 10-6. A lot of defense on both sides for both teams. But then in the third quarter, the Steelers were able to extend their lead to double digits when Ben Roethlisberger hit Jesse James for a 9-yard touchdown that made it 17-6. At this point, the Bengals had not gotten into the end zone, and they would not in the third quarter either, as Mike Nugent kicked his third field goal of the game, one in each quarter. This one a 21-yarder, and it was now 17-9 as the Bengals were down by 8 heading into the fourth. Then in the fourth quarter, about midway through, Roethlisberger hits D'Angelo Williams for a 4-yard touchdown pass, and that pretty much put the nails in the coffin, making it 24-9. And as I said, the Bengals at this point hadn't even reached the end zone. Of course, they weren't done, though, as Cincinnati kept on fighting, and Andy Dalton finally got the Bengals in the end zone with a 25-yard pass to Giovanni Bernard for the score, and it was a one-score game at 24-16, but with just 3.5 minutes left, it was too little too late, as the Steelers would hold on to win this one and get the victory, and they are now 2-0 on the season. The Bengals fall to 501-1, and I'll tell you, a very dominant performance by the Steelers defense, holding the Bengals out of the end zone until the final 3.5 minutes of the game, when the Bengals finally got their only touchdown of the game. Also on third downs, the Steelers defense was very dominant as they were shutting them down, as the Bengals were just 4-16 on third down, just 25%. But we look at Roethlisberger in this game. He was 9-37, 259 yards, 3 touchdowns. He did have the 2 interceptions, but they were able to overcome that. And then D'Angelo Williams, 32 for 94 on the ground, as he was carrying a heavy load there. And he didn't reach the century mark, but he was eating up the clock, and he was doing the work there in the trenches, pounding that rock. But he also had 4 catches for 38 yards, which put him over 100 total yards on the game. So he ended up with 132 total yards on the game. Roethlisberger actually had 14 yards off of 1 carry. But Sammy Coates, 2 receptions for 97 yards, was their leading receiver. Antonio Brown, just 4 catches for 39 yards. Set a lot of defense on both sides. The Bengals' defense was playing exceptionally well as well. But as well. Yeah, not a lot of offense, although big yardage out of Dalton. 366 yards, 31 for 54. But he had the 1 touchdown, no interceptions, but not much production on the ground for Cincinnati. Jeremy Hill, 11 carries for just 22 yards. And Bernard, just 5 carries for 17 yards. Although Bernard did have 100 yards receiving off of 9 receptions, giving 117 total yards. And he did have the only touchdown of the day for Cincinnati as he was on the receiving end of that touchdown from Dalton. But like I said, not much going on the ground as the Steelers' defense was just shutting down the Bengals' run. Boyd also had 6 catches for 78 yards for Cincinnati. But then we look at the defense. And for Pittsburgh, they had a sack. Moats had 1 sack and a forced fumble by Harrison. And then for Cincinnati, Adam Jones, Pac-Man with an interception, and Trey Kirkpatrick also with an interception. And the first downs, 21 for Cincinnati, 19 for Pittsburgh. But on third down, just 4 for 16 for the Bengals, just 25% converted. And for Pittsburgh, 7-17, 41% converted. Although on fourth down, the Steelers were 0-1 and Cincinnati was 1-1. And the Bengals actually had more total net yards at 412 to 374 for Pittsburgh. But on the ground, the Pittsburgh Steelers, 124 net rushing yards versus just 46 net rushing yards for the Bengals. Nearly 3 times as many net rushing yards for Pittsburgh. Although the Bengals had more net passing yards, 366 to 250, both teams allowing 1 sack. And we look at the penalties in this game. Both teams penalized 5 times, 31 penalty yards against the Bengals, 54 penalty yards against the Steelers. The Bengals, 2 costly fumbles, both of which they lost in this game. And in the red zone, the Bengals could not get into the end zone. It's just like on third downs in the red zone. The Steelers defense stepped it up, came up clutch, and they shut down the Bengals offense in the red zone, turning it into the dead zone. The Bengals 0-3, 0%. Not 1 red zone touchdown. They only had the 1 touchdown in the game. That was that 25-yard pass. And then in the red zone for Pittsburgh, 2-2, 100%. So if you stop the other team from scoring a red zone touchdown and you are not stopped, when you get in the red zone, 99 out of 100 times you're going to win that game. But 32 minutes, 55 seconds time of possession for the Steelers, 27 minutes, 5 seconds for the Bengals. They said it was a hard-fought battle. It was close early on. Pittsburgh really put in the lead extension in the fourth when they extended it for the second time into double digits, really putting it out of reach. Although the Bengals gave it their best, they almost, were right there. They're within a score. They would have needed the 2-point conversion to tie and send it overtime, but they were not able to muster enough offense to do that as the Steelers played consistent, great defense throughout the entire game. And even though their offense struggled at times early on, they got it together and they got the W. So a really hard-fought victory for the Steelers, a really impressive performance by their defense. The Bengals are playing some pretty good defense too, but the Pittsburgh Steelers come out victorious. Let me know though what you think in the comments section below, which plays and performances stuck out to you. Definitely interested to read your thoughts and opinions. Thank you very much for listening. It is greatly appreciated. I hope you're having a good day and had a great weekend, and enjoy all the sports.